Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Dominic Agace from Winkworth. Dominic, good to speak with you today.
Likewise, good to speak to you.
So Dominic, perhaps could we start with a little bit of background into Winkworth and about the company?
Winkworth has been established in 1835. It's a company that started franchising in 1981. It currently has 103 offices. 102 of those, 101 of those are franchised out, 61 of those are in London, and the remainder in the southeast, southwest of the UK. It grows at around, it's opened six new offices last year, and it grows by attracting new individuals who look to open up in new markets, taking on their shop and taking on the Winkworth brand and system to ensure their business is a success.
And it looks like a pretty good time to be an estate agency if you look at latest stats. So nationwide, with their January survey, the fastest growth in house prices since 2005, 11.2% rise in January. And so a good time for the sector.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, it's been what one couldn't have predicted at the time was the effect the pandemic has had on the property market and the number of transactions that have been created by the desire to move. So that wasn't to be foreseen. But as a result, since lockdown, the first lockdown was released, the property market's been incredibly busy. That was further fueled, obviously, by stamp duty cut holidays that the government introduced to sort of kickstart the housing market and the sort of ripple effect that has on the wider economy. But what's very encouraging is that, you know, those holidays have come to an end now. But what we've seen is the market incredibly busy. And as you say, I mean, the nationwide report sort of sums it up nicely in terms of it's the best, busiest January since 2005, I think they said. From our own statistics, what we've seen is that the applicants we're registering are higher. The last couple of weeks have been higher than we saw at any point in 2020. They've been the sort of fourth highest since we started recording in 2015. So it's been very busy on the sales side and on the letting side as well. Actually, it's the record number of lettings applicants we've received in the last couple of weeks since we started recording those as well. So both sides of the market have started very briskly this year.
I mean, Nationwide does, however, caution that things could slow down. Are you starting to see any signs of that?
Not really. I mean, I think there's always been the caution throughout this process, the last couple of years, about that. It's always felt that things could slow down, and every time the property market is surprised to the upside. I think there is a history to it being quite repressed due to other factors, you know, such as political uncertainty, the Brexit sort of shenanigans, subject to changes. So it's all of this led to it being fairly static for many years. So I think what you're seeing is a lot of that coming through, as well as the sort of pandemic driven factors. And, you know, what we're seeing, to say, is the applicants are very busy, but most interestingly is that we're also seeing a lot of valuations by our agents being undertaken. So valuations for us are lead indicators of properties then coming to the market to sell. And we're seeing the sort of valuations part of our business as busy as it has been since 2018. So in theory, we're looking for applicants to meet new properties to sell in the next month or so, making a very brisk market transaction.
I mean, Dominic, there have been suggestions that we're seeing a reversal of the trend out of London during the beginning of the pandemic, with people moving back into the city, having decided they made a bit of a mistake. Are you seeing that?
Yes, very much so. So I think our business, as I say, is quite geographically well spread. So, you know, we've got a significant number of offices out of the country markets in southeast, southwest that affiliate with London, and they, you know, really boomed, if one's honest, as a result of people, you know, working from home, thinking that's a permanent thing, or hybrid working, and a sort of general move to the country. But what we've seen in this latter part of 2021, is that the return to London. So that's been particularly evident in rentals, which have, you know, at the depths of the pandemic, daily rentals in London, prices went down by up to 20%. The students left town, people went home to live with their parents, people moved to the country generally because there wasn't a working life in the city. That has reversed, so we're now in positive territory for rental prices, so sort of above pre-pandemic levels. And we've seen that feed in the sales market, and I think what we'll see, that will feed into an active market for London this year in rentals and sales.
And of course, this all speaks to what you're seeing at Winkworth itself, because you were out with the trading updates a couple of weeks ago, and it looked pretty positive, particularly in the fourth quarter, with sales activity remaining brisk. Has that continued into the first quarter of the new year?
Yes, so we're pretty positive about the market's been and where we're going. You can say that the activity is there, it's woken up this year. It's always a key month, January, because it sort of sets the tone. You know, the registrations in January sort of set the tone for the rest of the year and what will unfold. And it's woken up very busy, which obviously is our sales business in 2020 was around 68% of our revenue. In sort of 2019, etc., was around 50-50 between sales and lettings revenue. But that sales business is remaining very active, which bodes well. And more than that, actually, from a sort of business network point of view, obviously we opened 6 new franchises last year, which is fantastic. And we have a sort of really good pipeline of around 8 that we've seen. The timings do move a bit dependent on shops and personal circumstances. But we can see those feeding into opening in the next 12 months or so. So the sort of expansion of the network on a non-capital basis. So obviously these are funded by the individuals coming to us, not by our own investment, is looking very positive too.
How about international interest in UK property and London property specific? Has that been curtailed by travel restrictions and the likes?
Yes, yeah. So I mean, I suppose the big story is looking at this year, at the end of last year when we looked at it, where, you know, rentals was going to be very strong in London as this sort of return to the cities was upon us and was obviously going to grow. And really, central London is the other element. And it's been interesting because every previous event, the sort of economic event, obviously this is not more than an economic event, but London, central London led the way out of property. You know, it's where international investments come in, it boomed, and then the effect is rippled out through London into the countryside and the southeast, southwest. This time around, it is the last one to move. And so that's because a large proportion of its buyers and sellers are overseas. So it's been improving. And again, it's moved into positive growth territory, but it's really been waiting for the sort of planes to start flying again and bringing those international businessmen and investors to the center of London again.
Would you expect any impacts from rising interest rates, Dominic?
I think the interest rates will, growth will outperform interest rates in my view. So I think they're fairly, we're at record lows in terms of interest rates and mortgage finance. You know, 5-year fixed at the moment still about 1.7%, which is incredibly cheap. And the future interest rates are projected to be, you know, by others to be at a slow pace over a longer period of time. And with a very strong labour market and a growing economy, we would expect that would kind of be absorbed in the property market and then allow it to continue moving forward. Mm-hmm. Albeit, I would suggest that the rapid price growth of the last 18 months, which was a surge, will slow. So I think it'll be a bit benign environment and perhaps with less rapid price growth.
Your full your results are due for release in April, so I know you can't say too much, but you have indicated that revenue has exceeded expectations and your pre-tax profit is also likely to be ahead of forecasts. So good news, obviously, for shareholders.
Yes, exactly, hopefully. The property market's been fairly static for a number of years, since 2014, and then the country market's probably going back to 2008, and it really has been waiting for it to move again, and then it has for the last couple of years, and at the moment the future looks bright. So hopefully shareholders will be happy going forward.
How about prospective investors? What would you put forward as the investment case for Winkworth?
So I think the investment case for Winkworth is that it is a low fixed cost model. So it is across a broad geography from country to London markets with 103 offices. The central costs are light. We have no debt. We have significant cash in the bank, enabling us to look at acquisitions at value. And we can grow at around, you know, about 8 to 10 offices a year, adding to that network and obviously bringing new revenue in at little cost to us.
Clearly, a very.
Also, I should point out, obviously, that as a result of that, we're able to pay a sort of fairly good dividend that is progressive going forward.
Well, I mean, that's always welcomed by shareholders. Dominic, let's leave it there. I'm sure we'll be chatting to you again in the future, but thank you very much for the update today.
Thank you very much. Cheers.